Database designs are closely related to database relationships, the association between two columns in one or more tables. Relationships are defined on the basis of matching key columns. There are three types of relationships in relational database design: one-to-one, one-to-many, and many-to-many. One-to-one relationship. This type of relationship is not common relationship type, as the data stored in table B could just have easily been stored in table A. However, there are some valid reasons for using this relationship type. A one-to-one relationship can be used for security purposes, to divide a large table, and various other specific purposes. This relationship can be created using primary key, unique foreign key constraints. One-to-many. The one-to-many relationship is defined as a relationship between two tables where a row from one table can have multiple matching rows in another table. This relationship can be created using primary key, foreign key relationship. Many-to-many. If for understanding many-to-many, we can say, let's suppose that students are enrolled in many courses. Each course has many students. A similar example is students and classes. One student attends multiple classes and each class contains multiple students. Doctors have many patients. Patients have many doctors. Customers have many bank accounts. Bank accounts might belong to more than one customer. Let's create our migration file. So start terminal. It's from view terminal. And let's create php artisan make migration, and we call it relationship. Then enter it. And I will create complete migration file in front of you. First, create our city table, call it schema, connection main city table, increment is ID true and unsigned. That's it. We will create another table, string name, and for city table we will name it, let's suppose 49, and by default we can do this empty, but we will not use it. We will do this, and for code we will assign three characters, and we will tell that the table engine is NOD. Now let's create connection on main, and for table city I will say insert, and then insert few records. We have name column. In name I will say Karachi. I will write Karachi. And code, I am not giving any code right now. And another city is Islamabad. So this is our city table. Schema, drop table city. This DB connection, not a schema connection, DB connection. So we created our first table. So now let's create student table. The student table, I'll copy this and paste this, name it to a student, first name and last name. That's it in your DB. Let's create some records here. In our student table, we have this first name and we have last name, and we can have another column in the table, integer and city ID, and it is unsigned. Okay, that's it, and we will assign it schema connection main create. We will not create. This says our table is student and function. We print table and like this, and say that this table has a foreign key at city ID and references ID and on table city. That's it. So this city ID has a reference on table city column ID. Now this city ID, let's suppose this first student is in city 1, and that's me. Let's call it yesterday and AAA's last name. B. So after city, I will say drop if exists. Save this. Now we have city table and student table. Now let's create another table. Let's create another table and name it student card table. This is card table. We have ID and we will use student ID. Student ID here, and we will have our card code. Card code may be of 32 characters, or it depends. And we will take another field. Boolean is active, and by default it's not active. So we will copy this from here to here, and we'll say that we have the card table and we have this student ID which belongs to the student table. And that's it, it created for us. Now let's insert some record in this table. We copy this. And in our table, we have this student ID. And let's say the student number 1. And its code is this. And for is active, yes. And for student number, for second student, we will do this. 111, and for third student and this card is not active. Save this. We have this student card and schema drop table if exist card. Save this. Is everything okay? Alright, so we have this student ID unsigned and remember to make it because it has 1-to-1 relationship. Save this and then we will create another table for subject. For subject, we will take this, copy this. I think I didn't close this bracket. This bracket. Now it's okay. Now we will create another table, and this one is for subject. Subject, and in subject we have name, let's suppose 49, and code for 3, that's it. And for inserting data, use this. In subjects we have name English, ENG, physics, PHY, and we have a third subject, chemistry, CHF. So we have this subjects table. Now also add this table in our drop line. Now for the final table, copy this and we name it student subject selection or course, whatever, student selection. So we have this integer and we don't need this increment. We say that I have integer, in integer we have a student ID and we call it unsigned. And in this we have subject ID unsigned, and say that table unique is student ID and subject ID. And let's have a relationship. On this student's selection, student ID, student, and for subject ID, subject. Now let's record, copy this, and in our student selection table, we name it student ID. Let's suppose the first student has selected English. And chemistry. And the second student selected physics. Save this, don't need any comma here, can remove this. And then drop table if exist. That's it. Open terminal, man without a PHP, artisan, migrate. Is active, insert into city, is active, values, unknown, column, is active. City table, where is our city table? Yes, student table, card, this is not city table, this is card table. So that's column not on, non column subject B. Well, what happened here? Set is and that's it. Our table, this is our table. Let's go to designer. So in this lecture, we created these tables for understanding relationship one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-one, and many-to-many. Thank you for watching this lecture, and I will see you in the next one in which we will perform our Eloquent relationship queries there. Take care. Bye-bye.